Today we are going to start a lecture series on communication system. So before moving toward communication system, I just want to give you an insight toward GATE syllabus as well as the marking scheme of the previous years also. So what I had found out that in the year 2016, for set 2 the marks is 10, and for the set 3 the marks is 11, for the set 1 the mark is 12. So on an average, if you count for previous year also, so overall weightage for communication system goes around 12 to 13 marks. So if you can secure around 12 to 13 marks in GATE from this subject, your rank will improve drastically. I mean, for even for 2 marks, your rank slips from 2000 to 3000 marks. Okay, 2000 to 3000 range. So this is the syllabus of GATE for communication system. I think it will also include your university syllabus also. So you can prepare for both GATE as well as your university examination from these lectures. So what I had done is I divide this syllabus part into some modules. So module 1 will contain review of signal and system, module 2 will contain analog communication, module 3 will contain digital communication including random variable and random process, module 4 will contain noise and communication system, and module 5 will be information theory. So let's get started toward it with our module 1, which is review of signal and system. So what is signal? A signal is a physical quantity which contain information. Okay, physical quantity which contain information. Okay, for example, voice is a signal, video signal, data signal which we are sending through mobile also is an example of a signal. So various signal we have, etc. Okay, now what is system? Okay, system is I can say it is a interconnection of devices. Which transform my signal. From one form to some other form. I will give you a simple example of this. Let us say we have a glass of water here. Normal water. Okay, now we have some refrigerator in our home. Okay, and if the temperature of the refrigerator is very negative, okay, so it will transfer my normal water to some cold water. So what is this? This act as a system. So basically refrigerator is an interconnection of so many devices inside the refrigerator. Okay, the refrigerator contains so many devices. So it is an interconnection of devices which transform my signal to some other form. Okay, so in terms, technically we can write it as like this. If x of t is my signal, okay, and there is some system. Let me draw some other color. Okay, this is my system h of t, then this signal x of t will transform into some other, that is y of t. Okay, so this is the definition of system. Now we will study some fundamental of signals, operation on signals. We need to study some operation on signal. I will give you some example on system also. So example of systems are amplifier, filters, attenuator, and etc. Many others. So what does amplifier do? Amplifier basically amplify my signal, increase the strength of my signal. Okay, what does filter do? Filter will clip my signal. Okay, and what does attenuator do? It will decrease the strength of my signal. Okay, so now I will classify my signal also. So I'll write down here classification of signals. Okay, so signals are broadly classified into two categories. It is first one, there is a deterministic signal. And other one is random signal. Now moving toward the first one, what is a deterministic signal? It's the one whose value we know at a particular, at a specific time, I would say. Okay, now whose value is known at a particular time. Okay, for example, I would say example like sinusoidal signal. Okay, because we know the value of this sinusoidal signal at a specific time interval. Okay, likewise, if I draw like this and it's move on like this, I mean it's continue with the period of time. Likewise, if it is sine of omega t, then you can see at t equal to 0 the value of this signal is 0, and for t omega t equal to pi by 2 the signal is 1. Okay, let us take it as omega t. So at omega t equal to 0 the value of the signal is 0, at omega t equal to pi by 2 the value of the signal is 1. Likewise, so we know the value of the signal at a particular or a specific time interval, so it is termed as deterministic signals. Okay, now what is a random signal? A random signal is likewise the voice coming out from my own voice. Okay, my own voice is also random in nature, and also we do not know the value of the signal at a particular instant of time, because my voice is also random. Okay, and all the communication system which we are going to study, all are random in nature. Likewise, you cannot predict those values. Likewise, the my voice would come something like this, or the system noise in our system would be, we can't predict it. A particular amount of time, we cannot say the value of this signal is this one. So with respect to time, and if the amplitude is A, I cannot say that this value is this much at this particular time interval, let's say T1. So it will vary. So a random signal is whose value is unknown to us at a particular time instant. Okay, so this is my random signal, and other one is my deterministic signal. So now we will study our operation on signals. So I have considered a signal x of t whose value is 1 in the interval -1 to 3, and apart from this the value of the signal is 0, as you can see in this graph. X of t is 1 in the interval -1 to 3, and otherwise it is 0. So we will study time shifting. First operation is time shifting. Okay, time shifting. Okay, so basically what we will do, we will shift our signal in the x-axis. Okay, now shift of signal in this axis. Okay, we can write it down as y of t is equal to x of t plus alpha. Okay. Alpha can be positive, alpha can be negative also. Okay. It can be real number, any real number. Okay. So let me write down the first one in this category is time delay. So it is basically shifting my signal in the right hand direction. Okay. Shifting my signal in right hand direction. Right hand side, we can say, is known as time delay. Likewise, if I draw a signal like this, here alpha is less than 0. Okay. Because that's why it is delay. My signal look like this. Okay, it is from minus 1 to 3. Okay, so this is my t, this is my x of t. Now let's turn to x of t minus 4 is my y of t. So my signal will look like, what I will do here in this side is, I will, wherever is there the term is, I will add this term there, 4 term. Okay, so I will add here 3 plus 4 and here also minus 1 plus 4. So it will become 3 and it will become 7. So my transform signal will look something like this. So it will be in positive direction. So look you something like this. It is from 3 to 7. That is y of t is equal to x of t minus 4. Now the second one is time advance. Okay, so in time advance, the value of alpha is greater than 0. Here we will shift our signal in left hand side or left hand direction. Okay, so what we have to do here is, we have to draw a signal. Our signal looks something like this. X of t is from minus 1 to 3. Okay, this is my axis t. Now I have to draw y of t. Let us say it is x of t plus 3. Okay, so what I will do here is that, let me take this color only. What I will do, I will subtract this 3 from this whole signal in the time axis. So 3 minus 3 equal to 0. And here what will become minus 1 minus 3 equal to minus 4. So my signal will look something like this. So minus 4 will come something like this. So my signal will look something like this. Okay. And one thing you have noted down here is that the width of the signal here it is 4. The width of the signal here it is also 4 unit. Okay. Of 4 time interval. And here also 4 time intervals. Okay. So we can say that it doesn't affect width of my signal. Okay. So in the next class, we are going to learn some other operation on signal also. You can download the PDF notes of this lecture at this website, that is gateonesolution.blogspot.in or gateonesolution.blogspot.com. Thanks for watching this lecture, and please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up if you like this video, and please spread it to your friends. Thanks and goodbye.